Hello and welcome to RORfm. I am your host Mahout, and my co-star.
I am still Jonathan Smith.
Yeah, I guess this is John Smith. Anyways, the big story today is that two snakes got in a fight in an unknown country at a university.
It was quite frightening, you know. This was in an undisclosed country, apparently, because I didn't know what the heck the people were saying. Although I could make out a few words like, oh my gosh, snake, snake, snake.
Are you sure? You know, when I saw you watching the video, it really looked like you knew exactly what they were saying. In fact, I even heard you quoting them in the original language.
There is no way that I would know what they are saying because I was born and bred in this country.
Anyways, back to the main topic. Cobras and pythons, the two fighting in the video, are some of the most deadly snakes in the entire world.
You know, this is true. You are not telling a lie here. Because I had two girlfriends. Their names were Cobra and Python, respectively.
That's real great, John. I'm sure all of our listeners really care to hear about all that. Anyways, we are lucky enough to have the two people who actually caught the snakes on the phone with us here today. They're on line one. RORfm, you're live.
Hello?
Now tell me, are you actually trained professionals, or did you just happen to be there at the time and wanted to save the day?
That was kind of strange.
John, can you actually translate that for me?
Certainly. They were basically saying that handling a snake is nothing that you should take too light. I have no clue what they were saying.
Are you sure? You sure? The viewers are really.
No. Why would you? I don't even know what country this is from. Why would I know?
Are you still on line one?
Hello, are you there? Oh, never mind. I hung up on them myself.
Are you kidding me? Do you know how long it took for us to get connected to them? All the transfers over and over?
But, you know, I just saved our listeners. They don't want to hear any of that. They saw the video. They saw the two snakes. They were fighting. They were making love. Who knows?
Well, I guess we're forced to move on to our secondary story of the day. In other news, there is an investigation in claw machines all across the country. And apparently, they're ripping kids off, only set to pay off every certain amount of plays, and it's all randomized, so you don't even know when they're going
to
pay out.
Yes, and I know these firsthand, because the other day I took my own children to one of those electronical game centers.
Are you talking about, like, an arcade?
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, I took them there. My child, he saw something that he wanted. He said, Daddy, it is so beautiful. So you know what I did? What? I pulled a quarter out. I put the quarter in. I picked up a stuffed animal. Fell back down. There was a tear in my child's eye. There was anger in my eyes. So you know what I did to get back at this stupid machine?
I don't think anyone really cares.
Well, you know what I did? I got my smallest child. I put him in the toy collection box, and I told him to go wild. I told him to get as many toys as his little heart pleases.
Well, I mean, that's all great in theory, but that's kind of illegal.
Well, yes, of course. Yes, of course it's illegal. You know, I was just telling a metaphor, you know. I was just trying to tell people that, you know, this kind of scam might cause people to go over the edge, you know, and do crazy things like this.
You know, I don't believe you in the first place, but I was actually watching the news last night, and I saw an extremely similar story.
Yes, of course. Oh, that was terrible. Oh.
So you're telling me that your kid's name isn't Joaquin Jimenez?
Well, first of all, it's Joaquin Jimenez. Oh, no, that's not my child's. My child's name is named after me. His name is John Jr.
You're sure?
Certain. Well, why do you keep accusing me, huh?
Okay. I just thought I'd ask.
We're supposed to be like partners here, you know, like Batman and Robin. You're Robin, or, you know, Robin's partner or something.
Actually, I would be Batman. You would be Robin.
In your dreams.
Well, that's the show for today. Thanks for tuning in to RORfm.
I can't believe I have to keep coming back here, but I probably will see you again tomorrow.
I can't believe you have to keep coming back here. See you tomorrow.